Panzer.
We're on my street, 31st Street, home stretch, and approaching 3rd Avenue here. I'm gonna catch a cab and go get a haircut. My buddy Martin is the best barber in the city, hands down. And just need to catch a cab, first one available. I don't. 57th Street. This is a barbershop. I got kicked in the nuts once. Yeah, and it wasn't funny at the time. Although, to the audience, it was still quite funny. But I was playing, I was going down for a shot. And the tables were lined up, you know, back to back. And then as I went down to shoot, a guy behind me decided to go and break. And if you're a professional, you're not, you know, you always look behind if there's, especially if you're breaking, you want to make sure this, you're not going to hurt anybody, right? But this guy didn't know better, and he went to do the break shot, and then his back leg kicked up right between my legs into the crotch. And I was like, I just, everything went black. So I had to like indicate timeout to my opponent and just like collapse in my chair. I heard a little snickering from the audience. I didn't think that was cool. In hindsight, it's kind of funny. And it was pretty brutal. And actually, to watch the guy, like obviously I didn't see him break when he kicked me in the nuts, but. So as our matches progressed, I was actually sitting in the chair and watching him break again and see how high his back leg kicked. And imagining my freaking, you know. Man, that wasn't fun. His back leg kicked like that high and my crotch is there. No good. I got a shit. Thanks, bro.
So how long have you been playing tennis?
Me? I don't play tennis. That's the whole joke.
But it's pretty exciting to go to the US Open spot because I've been there a few times to watch the actual championships. So it's kind of eerie to be playing there. I don't belong there. And it's kind of blasphemy to have me play in that.
You guys got hustled. This is New York, baby.
What's up, man?
Hey, this is Charlie, Corey and Dragon Williams, and we're at the Arthur Ashe Stadium, just about to play a little tennis, and I'm about to get my ass kicked.
It's tennis!
I think so, because, you know, he's been playing all, I don't know how many years now?
5 months.
months, every day. He's calling me every day to play tennis, so...
Yeah, Mika, get your ass down from New York City and play me some tennis in Florida.
Yeah, yeah. Well, no, the past week he's been calling me.
I was trying to get you to play last week, but yes. You were busy.
I was busy. I was actually working.
Take it easy on me today. I know you've been working out.
Right, yeah.
No.
Okay. Okay, so here we go.
All right, let's get it on. Ow! Edit that out, please. Cannonballs.
See, I wish pool could be like this. When you open up a can of pool balls, it don't sound like that. It sounds like you opened up a beer.
This is gonna open up a can of worms.
Open up a can of smell like worms. Open up a can of whoop ass.
Score. 3-0, John.
It's all right. I'm the Iceman.
See that? Think of the zoom on the shoe there. See what it says? It says dragon.
Does it?
Oh, yeah, you're right. It's dragon. They don't. Nike doesn't make Iceman shoes. But they make dragon shoes.
I don't have them, man. I'm gonna get mine.
I'm gonna have those. Nike dude, custom make me a shoe. It's Iceman. Definitely. There's a place in Soho that does the custom make Nike. I'm gonna show them.
Show them all, Mika.
Don't worry, it's gonna be all edited out.
I know.
Somehow, I won 6-2, 6-0, 4-0, but somehow I'm gonna look an idiot in this film, I know it, but it's okay.
Yet again, I think I did serve three aces.
You did serve three aces? Really? He did serve pretty good.
You didn't have any aces.
Yeah, what can I say, man? You got me there.
So at least one statistic I beat him.
One stat.
Say cheese.
Cheese.
Nice.
All right.
Good.
Cool. Right. Oh, my eyes are closed.
Uh-oh. You want another?
One more, please. Okay.
They look like they're closed anyway.
You.
Wow.
You get that on camera?
That's like 500 meters.
That was 500 meters? Oh, to the end. What we did was more than 100 meters, pretty sure. Here comes all the excuses now.
No, no, like,
well, the first time we raced was about 10 years ago, about 20, 12 years ago at the US Open. And then he was training for a, marathon. And every day I'm eating potato chips, watching him run. He's running 6-7 miles every day, right? He's in top shape. So one day I just go, Mika, I know I can't beat you in long distance, but I think I just beat you in a sprint though. But he looked at me and goes, he's like, didn't pay attention to me. I go, no, seriously. So we go outside and he's like, I can't believe you're gonna challenge me. I'm not gonna even stretch. Who won that race?
Some jackass.
Wow.
The last time I raced was on the beach, he says, you asked me to race after I ran harder than you. I ran faster than you.
Yeah, he made me sprint. One,
I didn't think you
stretched like this. I ran as hard as I could, and then he's like, okay, let's foot race.
No, I didn't make you. You just started running on, I was running together with you, then you just had to go past me. So like, okay.
He's so full of shit, man. That is full of shit right there.
Hey, all I know
dude,
is, hey,
I was sprinting.
Can you get this on camera?
The beach.
Who's the man?
Okay, well, we're here walking on 3rd Avenue. We just passed 12th Street. We're near one block from Management. Check out this pizza joint. This is one of the best local pizzas near Amsterdam, at least. You know, it's a good slice. Maybe a good late night chow sometimes if you get desperate. So we're gonna walk up about 9 blocks, go to this place called Barfly. I think some of my friends is playing a league game tonight there, so. Finland was pretty impossible for me to actually live there and make money because I had to travel so far to go everywhere. So naturally, first time I came over to the States was 96. And then I realized that I really like improve my game here, learn different style. I mean, I already had the European style down.
Thank you.
And got to know, I've seen Filipinos play a lot, but I figured for me, US and specifically East Coast was a good choice. The place where I live is called Murray Hill, but some people call it jokingly Curry Hill because there's a lot of Indian restaurants there. Which Nathan, I think you'd be interested in. There's a really good Indian vegetarian restaurant there.
I love foreign food. A lot of good vegetarian stuff.
So that's why New York is a good spot too, because you can get the best food, any ethnic food you can dream of, and it's real. It's the real deal. So if you can't get it here, you don't need it. That sounds like a cliche, right? But no, it's true. Okay, we're here now, Barfly,
yeah,
New York.
So, man.
Hi.
It's a wrap.
It's a wrap. We're
not yet. We're still freaking working here. Yeah, you got some
Veggie burger.
I got the burger.
Yeah. I didn't drop burger. Anything.
Still good?
Yeah, it's still good. Look at this.
So yeah, the hot seat match against O'Connell, he was playing phenomenal. He kind of shell-shocked me, and I just had to dig deep, you know. My friends came to me, you know, Marcus, Shamad, and Rodney, and all those guys. They were like, you know what, don't worry about it. You know, you're playing great. You know, it's just one match, and just recompose yourself and fight hard. And that's what I did, you know, just get back into it. I had to analyze the break a little bit, how I'm breaking, where's the cue ball, and the feel, the whole feel, and make sure I don't come to the match just 5 minutes before. I wanted to come like a good 15, 20 minutes and get a good warm up. So end up winning it. Then played good in the finals, and I got rid of one of the demons. And then the year, that fall went on, and actually went to Japan even before Moscone, and All Japan Championship was another funny ghost that I had, because I had been within the 10 years that I played in All Japan, I must have been I was 4 times in the final, and I lost every 4 times to a different person. So I was thinking, it's a different kind of animal here.
Sure enough, it was Alcano in the finals again.
And sure enough, Alcano was in the finals again, and I was like, well, you know what? I was playing really good there. I mean, just after the U.S. Open, everything went my way, and I felt like, okay, you know what? I'm just destined. People would joke about, oh, you know, you're gonna be second again. I'm in All Japan, and I'm like, you know what? So what? If I'm guaranteed second place every time, I'd be happy.
Money, but
it's pretty decent money. So I was breaking phenomenal. It was a side break. Balls were tapped in, so the corner ball was going pretty, like every time, pretty much. But you weren't allowed to break soft. That was a stipulation. So, but I was really hitting it square and parking the cue ball and getting good layouts. And I was up 3-1 against Alcano in the All Japan Championship Finals. And then I ran 7 in a row. So, we'll race to 11, he's down 10-1 now, and then he gets a shot. And now, talk about shell shock, he's like, just, you know, like, jelly. he shot one rack, next rack he missed, and I ran out. So that was it. So I got rid of ghost number 2. And then there was Moscone Cup, which I kind of screwed up 2 years before, and I was... deservingly so. I was booted out 2007. I didn't have a good year. I was kind of still depressed that the Moscone 2006 loss and me like screwing it up was one of the most devastating things that ever happened to me in my career. So I was depressed. And 2008, I wasn't like taking any chances. So first of all, I had a great season coming into it, and I worked hard, I made sure I was in shape, I was at the gym every day, I was like really, really good. And things just kept going my way, and I on a mental level I was like super strong, that, you know, nothing could shake me. So I ended up being MVP 2008. But of course it was a dream come true to be able to pot the winning 9 ball and then just seal it off. Qatar was like the one that started all the madness. And then Galveston, incredible field. Didn't go, I mean, a lot of the tournaments I had, like, I struggled, and, you know, I had to overcome, but like it was a lot of combats, a lot of like mental toughness and just getting into a habit of being in that the winner's circle every time. Kind of like I got used to the idea, and then just the body follows. The mind is there, the body follows. So coming again, like, you know, to US Open, I'm like joking in the beginning, you know, we had like this ceremony where the previous guy hands me the green jacket, and you're one of the champions now, and I'm like saying, it's a great honor, and then hopefully I don't have to give the jacket to anybody next year, because who knows, I might just repeat. I was like joking about it. But it came true, but it was definitely the biggest struggle, biggest marathon tournament that I've had in my life, and I don't know, it's going to be hard to repeat that one, just because I lost in the second round. I had to win 14 matches in a row to win. And one of those days I had 7 games, you know, including like an early morning, like 3, I think the game ended like 3:30 or 4 o'clock, and I had to wake up for an 11 o'clock match.
And you were trailing by over 6 games in several of those matches.
I was trailing in over 50% of the matches I was trailing.
Yeah, by significant amounts, yeah.
But then, you know, just kept coming back, just kept, like, you know, yeah, refused to fold, you know.
And you,
I usually ended the matches strong, like, you just, like, after I caught up, I was able to, like, just, you know, cruise past and just, like, close the door on the guys. And that became, like, a trademark of that tournament, like, you know, just not never being out of business, never.
So what's your favorite tournament then? Moscone Cup? I guess that's not really a tournament, but an event. But.
Overall? I gotta say one more thing. Like, you know, after all that craziness, I still had to go to, I still went to Manila. And they're asking me at the press conference, so what contributes to this success that you had? And what do you think of your chances here? I'm like, looking around, I see all these great players. I'm like, oh, you know, I've worked hard and did the right things, and I've, you know, managed to, like, struggle, but, you know, still come out ahead. And then, but the biggest thing was, like, having a nice mix between confidence and humility. So at the same time, you know, being reminding yourself, yeah, you know, you're good, you can do it, without getting too cocky. So that was the biggest thing. And then just do this, working hard, you know, just working out, staying healthy. And then winning there was just like what?
Yeah, and then once again, you didn't just win, you won with authority. That final set, you played very well.
Yeah, I remember that one. That was an awesome feeling, man. I happen to be here with my good friends, Tony Robles, Tony's girlfriend, Gail, who happens to be the Kiss of Death captain, the one that won the team that won the BCA Nationals, and also Thorsten Homan. He used to be, like, coming here all the time, but now he's moved to Florida. He's, you know, found peace there. And, you know, this is an awesome place. All the professional players, when they're in town, they're always visiting, and they treat us nice. You know, we always get entertained, and it's a great place to hang out, but also, it's a serious place to play pool. Tony, good to see you again.
Hey, thanks.
I hope I can make it to dinner.
Nice to see you, Tony.
Thorsten, you should come more often.
I'll see you soon.
Come to dinner.
I'll try.
Scared money don't make money, the damn thing funny. Hustling on the block, you scared, huh, honey? Don't snitch, do time, toughen up, sonny. Or niggas all rough, you up, dummy. A hustler, that's what you become. Action speaks louder than words, you holding your gun. Can't be scared when you live the fast life. Jewelry fast, money fast, cars ain't no housewife. Different bitch every day, now that's life. But you're getting high, start seeing cops by your spots. So then you get slow money, slow cars. No
other choice, but the didn't see that.
Oh. Life is like a game of DC dice. The only time out is when you pray to Christ. Then you right back in, committing the same sins. You were scared, so you lost money. That's what you get for being scared. Money don't make money, the damn thing's funny. Hustling on the block, you scared, huh, dunny? Don't snitch, do time, toughen up, sonny. Or niggas will rough you up, dummy.
So what you want, weed, XH, or Perico? I'm one in my way like Limp Bizkit and Carlito. I'm dirty, get the brass knuckles like Billy Rigo.
like a glance off the 8 and get position on the 5. Over here, it's a thin cut.
For love, getting stitches for these bitches. They all about dough, they aiming for your riches. Young age, show no love to these bitches. I'm like 50 in banks, I'm all about the cake. Never sleep, stay awake. Gully niggas push heavyweight. Don't try to perpetrate, gunshots penetrate. I guarantee that your ass will never ever hate. It's mine, it's a takeaway. The buy, you break away. You add, then you make a cake. Equal sign, equals dollar sign. That means you earning a major pay. But if you scared, son, you ain't shit, son.
Scared money don't make money.
And I'm screwed. Officially screwed. What I have to do here? Some magic?
Those niggas clap on the way to the top with no figures. I stretch out grams of dope like 4 fingers and flip that shit to like 4 G's or bigger. I guess that cake I hustle gold diggers and send them to you to make me more richer. You saw what I have, seen what I got. Big chain, big ring with the bracelet and watch. You gotta get on your grind, on your block. You gotta get on your shine in your spot. Take it from me, we got the game locked.
Wow. That was strong. No, I like to study, especially if I didn't do that well. Obviously, then there's more to study, because, you know, if you didn't do things right. So you want to kind of like analyze them and get rid of those kind of mistakes, you know. I try not to do any mistake twice. So if I do a mistake, I'm not really like, I mean, I have to say I'm a little bit of a perfectionist when it comes to playing pool. And I don't take mistakes lightly, so I guess that kind of puts me where I'm right now. Before, when I hadn't even won the US Open, I was thinking, how did Nick do it twice in a row? Like, that was sick. Now I'm sick. I'm a sick bastard. Well, to me, there's so many different angles to approach, and I mean, you can never be mentally too strong. I think that's a side that it can always develop, and the same goes for physical. I mean, of course, as we get older, you can't do the same things that you used to do when you're a kid, but at least I can feel comfortable in my own skin and do what I can do to slow down the process of aging, maybe, you know, something like that. But then also do more things, not just like running that I used to do a lot when I was younger. But now I'm bringing other things, you know, like yoga and tai chi, little stuff from martial arts. You know, I have some good friends that are like really good at it, so I'm learning things as we go, and you know, learning things about breathing, which is big in martial arts and yoga. So there's a saying, if you can't control your breath, you can't control your life. So I think that's a key. Even in a match, if you can't control your breath, you can't control the game. So there's so much more to that stuff that, you know, people don't understand. I mean, the general public, all they know is like Minnesota Fats and, you know, something like that, you know, who's the most famous player. But now pool is a sport, and I'm bringing it to another level. So whoever else out there, you know, trying hard, you know, they're not trying hard enough unless they're hitting the gym or, you know, going running or, you know, reading books about mental game, you know, whether it's mental game in pool or tennis or golf. And you can all, it's all related. So I think I'm working more angles than the other guys. So that's what gives me an edge.
Well, I think a lot of people, when you mention physical strength and whatnot and endurance, a lot of people doubt it. They don't understand pool as being a physical sport. But the U.S. Open, 2009 U.S. Open, was a perfect example of endurance and stamina, physical strength.
Yeah.
I mean, without that, you would not have persevered through 14 matches across the loser side to win.
Yeah, that definitely sets the record straight. You know, like, I think maybe at that point, some players figured out, okay, you know what, I gotta go to the gym. Like, I mean, everybody knows it only helps, but still they're lazy to do it. So I think my message to other, you know, aspiring professionals or current professionals, you gotta like work a little harder if you wanna excel at the game. And I don't mind you guys, you know, I don't mind the other guys working harder and getting better, because I wanna be still the best, no matter how good they get, you know. So that's why I'm okay with sharing knowledge, whether it's about physical conditioning or about the game itself.
It doesn't matter. I'm speaking cut.
Yeah,
pause.
Yeah.
Like I can do it like this, and
yeah, yeah. It's fun.
Oh.
Yeah,
I get that.
Yeah. Oh, you can't cut that.
Yeah, let's just...
We're pretty much there.
Just right? Wrap it up.
Yeah, okay. Good.
I'll go to another bar. So, all right, people in the home front, thanks for tuning in to this video feature. And hopefully you'll find it interesting and you'll find a little bit more about me as a person and not just the Iceman. So this is Mika, the real deal. I'll see you again on the road.
This is John Moore, you're watching Runout Media.
Yes.